Hey, welcome to Storytime. Thank you for coming. My name is Elizabeth Reimer, and I am the director of Freedom Public Library here in New Hampshire. Welcome to everyone, and I want to give special shout outs to my local Storytime friends. Who is this woman of mystery? Why, I believe it's Lily. Here are Josie, Elsie, and Darla in their summer reading t-shirts, and hi to Piper, who's not pictured. Here are Jackson and Anna at the beach, their favorite place. Haley and her lovely heart mobile. Here's Evan and his heart mobile hat. Frog hunters Elsie, Jack, and Beau. And here's Declan with his awesome spider. Colin showing off his spectacular heart mobile. Don't look now, Caden, but there's a spider on the other side of your chair. Bennett and Michael with the cattle. Nice job on the heart mobile, Ashton. Here's Araya and Joey. They're rocking their mustaches. Amelia and her terrific heart headband. Abigail made a heart poster, and so did Anna. Nice job, girls. If you would like to be included in an upcoming Storytime shout-out, send me a picture to the email address down below. And now it's time to sing our Storytime song. You know it by now. Let's sing together. Sit down, it's story time, and we are gonna have some fun. Read books and sing some songs, so listen everyone. I like to see your eyes grow bright, I like to see you smile, 'cause you're all growing up so fast, let's share this little while. So sit down, it's story time, and we are gonna have some fun. Read books and sing some songs, so listen everyone, listen everyone. It's boat story time this week, and my first story is Toy Boat. Toy Boat by Randall de Sève and Loren Long. A little boy had a toy boat. He made it from a can, a cork, a yellow pencil, and some white cloth. The boy loved the boat, and they were never apart. They bathed together, they slept together. And every day they would go down to the lake and sail all afternoon. The boy held the boat by a string and never let go. Most of the time this was nice for the boat, but sometimes the little toy boat would look out at the big boats gliding across the lake and wonder what it would feel like to sail free. One blustery afternoon, a dark cloud rolled over the lake. The boy's mom pulled him back toward the house. Her tug made him drop the boat's string. The boy cried out as the little toy boat floated away. "Boat!" he called. "Boat!" But nothing could be done. Gosh, they're far away from each other now. Wind and rain pushed the little toy boat into deep water. There it bobbed on high waves topped with foam. In time, a black and green tugboat with a row of old tires on its side chugged past. Its windows looked like tired eyes that seemed to say, "Move along," as it pushed the little toy boat aside with its wake. The little toy boat worked so hard to stay afloat, it almost didn't see the giant ferry in its path. The ferry had two flags and a red smokestack and a horn that bellowed, "Boom! Move along!" A gust of wind blew the little toy boat out of the way just in time. What kind of boat is that? A speedboat raced by, flat and sharp with flames on its side. Its motor screamed, "Move along!" Its draft made the little boat's sail quiver. Feeling small and scared, the little toy boat drifted out toward a fleet of sailboats racing home to get out of the rain. Whew. They're going so fast. The little toy boat neared a large sloop. That's another word for a a big sailboat, sloop. Its hull was white and its sails were trimmed in blue. For a moment, the two boats cut through the choppy wave side by side and the little toy boat felt big. Then the white boat tilted high on its side, spraying the little toy boat with water, warning, "Move along!" Its hull near full, its sails soaked, the little toy boat looked like it would sink. How it missed the boy. Look, it's like drooping. It did pretty well so far, huh? Oh, looks like the moon is sad. Under the yellow moon, the little toy boat drifted all night, alone and scared. But then, early in the morning, put, 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 put. It was a humble little fishing boat way out in the middle of the lake. Its paint was peeling and the dents on its side said it knew how it felt to be pushed around on the lake. The fishing boat spied the little toy boat and carefully began to circle it. As it did, something wonderful happened. The little toy boat began to turn as well, and its sail caught a breeze. Soon it was sailing, really sailing, alongside the fishing boat, and the little toy boat felt strong. "I'm moving along," it shouted to the wind. "Look, it is going." It felt so good that it didn't notice when the fishing boat motored on. It didn't notice the stone beach or the yellow bench on the nearby shore, and it didn't notice the boy. Not until he called out, "Boat! Boat!" The little toy boat waved its sail excitedly, and the little boy waved back. That night, they bathed together. They slept together, and the next day they went down to the lake together. The boy held the boat by a string and ever so often let go, but the little toy boat always came back. It knew just where it wanted to be. Toy boat. Okay, I made a new flannel for boat story time. Look at these. Aren't they beauteous? Blue one. What color is this one? Pink and orange and yellow and what's that one? Green. Five. Five little boats sailed out one day over the waves. Can you do that? Over the waves and far away. When the wind blew hard, they began to rock, and one little boat returned to the dock. How about this one? The yellow one. Now how many do we have? One, two, three, four. Four sailboats. Four little boats sailed out one day, over the waves and far away. When the wind blew hard, they began to rock, and one little boat sailed back to the dock. Now there's three. Three little boats sailed out one day, over the waves and far away. When the wind blew hard, they began to rock, and one little boat returned to the dock. Pink one. Two little boats sailed out one day over the waves and far away. When the wind blew hard, they began to rock, and one little boat returned to the dock. How many's left? One little boat sailed out one day over the waves and far away. When the wind blew hard, it began to rock, and the last little boat returned to the dock. Just like that toy boat, the wind blew hard and blew it right out into the middle of the water. It was hard to get back. I bet you know this boat song. Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream. Want to sing it again with me? Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream. How about this one? Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. If you see a crocodile, don't forget to scream! Ah! Row, row, row your boat gently down the Nile. If you see a camel there, don't forget to smile. Are you smiling? Row, row, row your boat gently down the river. If you see a polar bear, don't forget to shiver. Row, row, row your boat gently to the shore. If you see a lion there, don't forget to roar. Did you make a good roar? Sorry. Row, row, row your boat gently down the creek. If you see a mouse there, don't forget to squeak. Good job. Splashing up and down in my little red rowboat. Splashing up and down in my little red rowboat. Splashing up and down in my little red rowboat. I just love the ocean. Do you love the ocean? Okay, how about this? Looking out to sea in my little red rowboat, looking out to sea in my little red rowboat, looking out to sea in my little red rowboat, I just love the ocean. Waving to a whale in my little red rowboat, waving to a whale in my little red rowboat, waving to a whale in my little red rowboat, I just love the ocean. Better not stand or I might tip over. Better not stand or I might tip over. Better not stand or I might tip over. I just love the ocean. Yay! Okay, now I have a song that we're going to do with some music by Ellen and Peter Allard. Thank you very much for letting us use your music today. This song is called Down by the Ocean and it has some hand gestures we'll practice together.
Dolphins,
dolphins,
diving,
diving,
dolphins,
dolphins,
oh.
Hannah and Jackson, who love the ocean, and for everyone else who loves the ocean too. So now it's time to sing about you. Take a second to look at what you're wearing right now. What are you wearing? I've got my dot dress. I've got my pretty silver earrings that I got at Emerson and Ryland's yard sale. Thank you guys. But I don't think I'll sing about either one of those things. I'm gonna sing about my new glasses. Yay, I got new glasses. Ready to sing for me? Elizabeth's wearing her new glasses, her new glasses, her new glasses. Elizabeth's wearing her new glasses all day long. Please take a bow. Yay, Elizabeth! Yay, Elizabeth! So we're really happy to have Colin, Evan, and Ashton here with us today to sing about them. Who wants to go first?
I'll go first.
Okay, Ashton, what are you wearing today?
My sunglasses.
What do you want to say about your sunglasses? Anything?
My flag sunglasses.
Okay, all right. You guys ready to sing flag sunglasses? Ashton's wearing his flag sunglasses, his flag sunglasses, his flag sunglasses. Ashton's wearing his flag sunglasses all day long. Please take a bow. Great. Who's next?
I'll go next.
Okay, Colin, what do you want to sing about?
My USA hat.
Yeah, very cool. All right, ready to sing? Colin's wearing his USA hat, his USA hat, his USA hat. Colin's wearing his USA hat all day long. Please take a bow. Yay! No clapping again. Yay! Okay, your turn now, Evan. What are you wearing?
My new shoes.
They're new?
Yeah, my new shoes.
Very nice. Okay. Evan's wearing his new shoes, his new shoes, his new shoes. Evan's wearing his new shoes all day long. Please take a bow. Yay! All right. Won't it be fun to see yourselves on the video?
Yeah.
All right, cool. Thanks for coming. So my next book is called Who Sank the Boat? By Pamela Allen. Here's a house. It's got a long dock and I see a boat there. Beside the sea on Mr. Peffer's place, there lived a cow, a donkey, a sheep, a pig, and a tiny little mouse. Squeak! They were good friends, and one warm sunny morning, for no particular reason, they decided to go for a row in the bay. Do you know who sank the boat? Was it the cow who almost fell in when she tilted the boat and made such a din? No, it wasn't the cow who almost fell in. Do you know who sank the boat? Was it the donkey who balanced her weight? Who yelled, "I'll get in at the bow before it's too late"? No, it wasn't the donkey who balanced her weight. Do you know who sank the boat? Looks like it's okay right now. Was it the pig as fat as butter who stepped in at the side and caused a great flutter? Look at those faces. Ah! Careful, careful! No, it wasn't the pig as fat as butter. Do you know who sank the boat? Look at them now. Those are big animals. Was it the sheep who knew where to sit to level the boat so that she could knit? Here she comes. Is she knitting herself? No. No, it wasn't the sheep who knew where to sit. Do you know who sank the boat? There are four of them. Nice and balanced. Was it the little mouse, the last to get in, who was lightest of all? Could it be him? Whee! Took a leap. You do know who sank the boat. What happened? Oh, they're all drenched, coming up out of the water. Uh-oh, the oar is floating away, and there goes the umbrella. Who sank the boat?
We're gonna use our shakers. We're gonna use our shakers. Do you have a shaker? If not, you can get a little snack container and put some rice in it, maybe. What else could you use? My Easter egg filled with rice. That's how I made them for you guys. Some of you have that. If you still have it, I hope so. All right. Shake your shaker in the air. Shake it here. Shake it there. Shake your shaker in the air. Shake your shaker. Okay, let's do that again together. Ready? Shake your shaker. I'm gonna do that over and over again, so practice it, all right? Shake it high and shake it low. Shake it yes and shake it no. Shake it high and shake it low. Shake your shaker. Shake it near and shake it far. Drive your shaker like a car. Shake it near and shake it far. Shake your shaker. Shake it fast and shake it slow. Shake it stop and shake it go. Shake it fast and shake it slow. Shake your shaker. Shake it front and shake it back. Pretend to eat your shaker like a snack. Shake it front and shake it back. Shake your shaker. Shake it left. Let's see, over here. Shake it left and shake it right. Squeeze your shaker with all your might. Shake it left and shake it right. Shake your shaker. Shake it up and shake it down. Rub your shaker on the ground. Shake it up and shake it down. Shake your shaker. Yay! Going to Kentucky, going to the fair, to see the señorita with flowers in her hair. Oh, shake it, shake it, shake it, shake it high and low. Shake it like a milkshake as fast as you can go. Shake it, shake it, shake it, faster, faster. It's a blur. Oh, wobble to the bottom, wobble to the top. Now turn around until I tell you. Stop. Okay. All right, we're shaking on our shakers. We're shaking on our shakers. Hi-ho the derry-o, we're shaking on our shakers. We're shaking left and right. We're shaking left and right. Hi-ho the derry-o, we're shaking left and right. We're shaking on our heads, we're shaking on our heads. Ow! Hi-ho the derry-o, we're shaking on our heads. We're shaking and we're jumping, we're shaking and we're jumping. Hi-ho the derry-o, we're shaking and we're jumping. Let's see what else. We're shaking on our tummies, we're shaking on our tummies. Hi-ho the derry-o, we're shaking on our tummies. What else? How about our knees? One knee and then the other knee. We're shaking on our knees, we're shaking on our knees. Hi-ho the derry-o, we're shaking on our knees. shaking on her elbows, shaking on her elbows. High for the dealio, we're shaking on her elbows. We're shaking with our eyes closed, we're shaking with our eyes closed. Hi ho the Dario, we're shaking with our eyes closed. And open and open and close and open and close and open and close and open and close.
This is a cute book called Captain Small Pig by Martin Waddell and illustrated by Susan Varley. It's another book with animals in the boat. One day, Old Goat and Turkey took Small Pig down to Blue Lake. They found a little red boat.
I want to go for a row, Small Pig said, dancing about.
Turkeys don't go in boats, Turkey said.
Neither do goats, said Old Goat.
But he climbed into the boat and they rowed off onto Blue Lake.
I want to fish for whales, said Small Pig.
There aren't any whales in Blue Lake, said Turkey.
There might be a very small whale, said Old Goat,
and he tied a string to an oar so Small Pig could try his whale fishing.
Will they catch one?
Maybe.
Oh, Small Pig didn't catch any whales, but he caught an old boot, which was almost as good.
That was pretty exciting.
I want to row now, said Small Pig.
You're too small to row, Turkey objected.
Of course you can row, said Old Goat.
Small Pig could only manage one oar at a time. So he rowed round and round, round and round, but he rowed the boat all by himself. Did you know that if you only row on one side of a canoe or a kayak or a rowboat, you'll just go around in one around and around and not go forward or backwards. Oh, there's some more round and rounds up there. I missed that one.
I'm Captain Commander, Small Pig said.
Turkey just shook his head sleepily.
Aye, aye, Captain Small Pig, said Old Goat. You are in charge of this boat.
Well, I'm too tired to row anymore,
Small Pig said.
I knew you would be, said Turkey. Just let the boat drift, said Old Goat, yawning, but keep your hand on the tiller.
As the moon rose, the boat drifted back through the reeds toward the shore. Small Pig was sort of steering the boat, and then Small Pig sort of wasn't steering the boat. He'd fallen asleep holding his boot. The boat was sort of steering itself.
My turn to steer, sighed Old Goat.
He took over the tiller and guided them back to the dock. As they drew near, Old Goat rose out of his seat to tie up the boat. It rocked one way and then the other until... What's going to happen?
Sploosh!
Whoopsie!
Oh, my hat! I knew this would happen!
Spluttered Turkey.
Shh! We mustn't wake up Captain Small Pig,
Old Goat warned Turkey. They carried Small Pig all the way home, wrapped warm in a blanket, and they tucked him cozily into bed. Small Pig slept, and he dreamed of a lovely day out in a boat with good friends on Blue Lake, the day that he was Captain Small Pig. Do you have a boat at your house? Maybe one that you blow up? Or maybe a motorboat, or a fishing boat, or maybe a kayak. Do you have a boat, or have you ever been in a boat? Well, if you don't have a boat, you will soon if you got some craft supplies from the Freedom Public Library. This is what it's going to turn out like. The boat on the water. This is the yarny water in the sunshine. Does it look like a nice place to go sailing? So what you'll need for this craft are, let's see, a light blue plate with holes and a dark blue plate with holes. Or you could just color, you could have plain white plates and color them yourself. The holes line up, so punch the holes together with a hole punch. And then we have a sun. And this is the hull of the boat, the part you sit in. And here are the sails. Here's the sail. Okay, and we need some glue. And we need some glue, that is, and we need some tape, and we need some yarn. And one end of it has some tape on it so that it can go through the holes a little bit easier. And one end does not have it. And what we're gonna do with that part is tape it to the back of the plate to hold it tight. Otherwise, you just pull it all the way through again, okay? So we're just going to tape the back of the plate. Now, going to have to hold both of them together until we get them sewed together. All right, so take the end. There it is. Okay, now I've got it taped to the back. I'm going to take this end and go through from the back to the front, coming through the holes like that. And then I get to choose, where do I want to go next? How about over here? Over there. And pull it. Okay, look, I got one going that way. And now we go from the back, maybe right here. It's long. So now we got that one. Now I think I'll go over here to this one here. So you just keep on sewing back and forth. Back and forth. When your yarn is at the back, you want to go through the back for the next time. And if your yarn is in the front, you want to go back through the front. So I'm going to go back over here. And I'm going to, oh, I got caught on the scissors. Stop, scissors. Now it's at the back, so I'm going to go in through the back again. And pull the yarn, and now I'm going to go down through here. So you do as much as you want to, and then we'll glue our boat and our sun on, okay? So we'll finish up by going to the back, and then you can tape the other end, your final end, to the back like that. And now we've kept it so that the two plates are stuck together with the yarn. We also need some glue and the sun. So here's my sunny, sunshiny day. Okay. And now I got my boat sitting in the blue, blue water. Maybe it's tipping a little bit because the wind is blowing a little. Just a little bit like that, maybe. Let's try it. Let's put some glue on the back of my hull. So let's see. Here's my hull. I glued that there. Okay, so now I'm going to put this right like that. Sailing, sailing over the, what is it? I don't know. Anyway, listen, I want to tell you who did these things. Luann Janest created this wonderful craft for us, and Bonnie Burrows cut out the boat parts for us and the sun. So I want to thank both of you lovely ladies for helping us at Storytime make this beautiful boat craft. I hope you had fun today. I'd love to see your boat crafts, how it turned out for you. And if you have a boat and you want to take a picture of yourself on your boat, that would be fun too. Whatever you want to do, send it to me. I'd love to see it. See you next week. Okay? Bye for now.